Sneha, you are watching this video on the channel India's Learner. Guys, we will continue the chapter 4 agriculture in this video from the NCERT series of geography of class 8. In this video, we will mainly discuss the part 2 of the chapter. Those who have missed the part 1 of this chapter, you can go to the link box and then watch it. So let's move to the part 2. In the part 2, we will mainly discuss the two major topics. These are key points of the part 2 of the chapter 4, geography, agriculture. In this video, we will mainly focus on the topic farm system, and our next topic will be types of agriculture. In the topic farm system, we will learn and understand that how the farm system works, what are the inputs required in a particular form of farming, what are the processes have to be done in order to get the required output. Later on, we will discuss that what type of different types of agriculture are practiced in all over the world, and yes, what are the features of each of them in detail we will know. So let's move to the first topic, that is the farm system. Our first topic is farm system. So friends, as we know, with every form of agriculture, so many activities are done. In all those activities, a variety of inputs are required. All these activities collectively form a system which works in the general way, like every system. That is called the farm system. In the farm system, all the activities are done in the general way, like in every system works. These are inputs, process, and output. Input, process, output. Inputs. Inputs are the factors that a farm needs to work with. It is mainly divided into two categories. These are, one is the physical inputs, which mainly include the naturally available things. These are sunshine, temperature, rainfall, soil, and the leaf. Physical inputs that are required in the agriculture: sunshine, temperature, rainfall, type of soil, and the leaf means terrain of the land. And the human inputs also affect or plays an important role in every form of agriculture. For example, labor, storage, capital, machinery, skills, etc. Yes, chemical and fertilizers, which are also required in every type of farming. These all are the human inputs. Human brought it to the farmland to be processed it in the second part and then to get the required output. Processes. Processes are the actions that are needed to be done in order to get the required output with the inputs. Mainly, the process of agriculture, we can see the different kinds of activities or the actions which are done in order, that is, first is plowing. Next is sowing, then irrigation, then weeding, and yes, in the last, harvesting. Plowing, to plow the fields, sowing, to sow the seeds, irrigation, to supply the water in adequate amount to the farmland, weeding, to remove the unwanted part of the plant, harvesting, to ripe the crops. In every form of agriculture or to produce the crops, mainly first we will ready the farmland by plowing the field. Then we sow the seeds in it by different methods. Then we supply the water through different methods in adequate amount as per the crops required. And yes, time to time we also remove the unwanted part of the plant, and later on when the crops are ready, they are harvested and sent to the market for selling. And then yes, we get the output. After completing all these activities in the process with the inputs required in the different kinds of agriculture, we get outputs in different forms. Depends on the agriculture or the raw materials or the seeds that are used in the agriculture or the farming. Some of the outputs are wool in nomadic herding especially, silk in sericulture, dairy product in dairy farming, fishing product in pisciculture, poultry product in poultry, crops in crop production or agriculture of the different crops or the cultivation of different crops. So let us discuss our next topic, that is types of agriculture. Our next topic is different types of agriculture. Agriculture or farming generally depends on the demand of produce, geographical structure of the land, labor, and the level of technology that is used in the particular type of farming. So yes, to know more about the agriculture or the types of farming, we should classify it into two categories. These are subsistence farming. Another one is, which is practiced on a large scale, that is commercial farming, subsistence farming and commercial farming. Subsistence farming is further divided into two categories. These are primitive subsistence and another one is intensive subsistence. Primitive subsistence farming are practiced in mainly two forms, that is shifting cultivation and in another form economic theory. Whereas the commercial farming is divided into three categories. These are commercial grain farming, mixed farming and plantation. So here types of agriculture are of two types, subsistence and commercial farming. Subsistence is further divided into two categories, primitive and intensive subsistence, whereas primitive subsistence is practiced in two forms. These are shifting cultivation and nomadic herding. Whereas the commercial farming is further divided into three categories. These are commercial grain farming, mixed farming and plantation. So let us know more about each of them in detail. Move to the next topic, that is we will discuss that what is the meaning of subsistence farming and commercial farming, and also know about the difference between these two. So let's move to the next topic, subsistence farming. And the next one is the commercial farming. Subsistence farming and commercial farming. Let us know about their meaning and the difference between these two step by step. So first we will go through their meaning. This type of farming is mainly practiced to fulfill the needs of farmer's family, to fulfill the needs of farmers, family. And commercial farming, as its name refers, it is generally done to sell in the market for the selling purpose. It is mainly practiced to earn money and to gain more and more profit. So subsistence farming is generally done to fulfill the needs of farmer's family, and the commercial is mainly done to sell in the market and to gain more profit. Here in subsistence farming, the area or farm or the farms are small in size, whereas in as comparison to the subsistence, in this commercial farming, farmlands are relatively large. A large stretches of land are used for commercial farming. In the subsistence farming, low level of technology is used. Simple tools and traditional machines are used in the subsistence farming, whereas in commercial farming, modern techniques and tools are used. In subsistence farming, yes, it is mainly done through the household labor, and commercial farming, because it's a produce the large amount of production, so it used or employs large number of people and trained labor is worked in that. In this type of subsistence farming, less amount of capital, very less amount of capital is required, because here mainly the farming is done through the help of household labor and low level of technology are used. Farms land are small, production is also very less. So yes, less amount of capital is required in that. Whereas as comparison to subsistence, in commercial farming, it requires huge amount of capital, subsistence farming. farming are further divided into two categories. These are primitive, as we have earlier discussed in the flowchart, primitive and intensive subsistence farming. Whereas the commercial farming is divided into three main categories, which are commercial green farming, mixed farming, and plantation. So yes, let us know more about each of them in detail in the next topic. Intensive subsistence farming. Intensive subsistence farming. In intensive subsistence farming, on a small plot of land, using the simple tools and traditional machines, with having a large number of laborers, farming is mainly practiced. In this type of farming, we can produce only one crop, annually in a year. The main crops that are grown in this type of farming are rice, wheat, the cereal maize, oil seeds, pulses, etc. The reason where this type of farming is mainly practiced, needs the large number of laborers. So yes, the most populous continent we know, the Asia. In this, the intensive subsistence is mainly practiced. So the regions of South, East, and Southeast Asia, this type of farming is generally practiced. Let us discuss about the primitive subsistence farming. As we have earlier discussed in the flowchart, that primitive subsistence are practiced into two forms: shifting cultivation and nomadic herding. Let us first discuss what is the shifting cultivation, which are our next topic, that is shifting cultivation. Shifting cultivation are Shifting cultivation is mainly done by the tribal people of the tropical forest. In this type of farming, a plot of land is cleared by cutting and burning of trees. Then the ashes of the burnt trees mixed with the soil to improve its fertility. And the seeds are sown by dispersal methods and the different crops are grown. When the land loses its fertility, then the farmer moves to the another plot of land. Let us first discuss what is shifting cultivation. Shifting cultivation is mainly practiced by the tribal people of tropical forest. As this type of farming is mainly done in the thickly forested areas, so it is mainly practiced by the tribal people of tropical forest. In this type of farming, a plot of land is cleared by cutting and burning of trees. Then the ashes of the burnt trees is mixed with the soil to improve its fertility. And then the seeds are sown by dispersal method and the different types of crops are grown. When the land loses its fertility, then the farmer moves to the another plot of land. In this type of farming, the main crops are grown are some of the examples of the crops that are grown in this type of farming are yam, cassava, potato, oil seeds, etc. And the reason where it is mainly practiced is the thickly forested areas of Amazon basin in Southeast Asia Northeast India and in tropical Africa it is mainly done. Yes, it is also known by the other names in the different countries. Let us know more about them. The different names of slash and burn agriculture or the shifting cultivation is country and the names of slash and burn agriculture. Why is it called slash and burn agriculture? As we have discussed that in this type of farming we have two burn the trees, the vegetation found in the plot of land to grow the crops. So yes, it is also called the name of slash and burn agriculture. In Northeast India, in our country, in the northeast part, it is called Jhoom. In Mexico, it is known by the name Milpa. In Brazil, it is called Roca. In the country Malaysia, it is called Ladang. In Africa continent, the Congo basin, it is known by the name Mesol and etc. Our second form of primitive subsistence farming is the nomadic herding. Nomadic herding, as the name refers, that it is mainly done by or mainly practiced by herdsmen. Herdsmen which generally move from one place to another with their animals in search of water and fodder for their animals, and it is also called livestock farming. And the livestock includes the animals like goat, sheep, yak, camel, etc. And these are reared generally for the purpose or to get the items like milk, meat, hides, etc. And yes, it is mainly done in the regions of Sahara Desert, Jammu and Kashmir in our country. Jammu and Kashmir and etc. Now we are going to discuss the commercial farming, the different types. First we will discuss its first category, that is the commercial grain farming. Commercial grain farming. In this type of farming, only a single crop, generally a single crop is grown on a large tract of land. And the crops which are generally grown in this type of farming contains grains such as wheat and maize, which are generally consumed on a large amount by the people, and yes, with the good quality of seeds and using the modern machines or techniques, it is mainly practiced for the selling purpose in the market. And the reasons where the commercial grain farming is generally done are the grasslands, because as the grasslands are very much suitable for producing the different kinds of cereals. Reasons where the commercial grain farming is generally practiced are temperate grasslands of Asia, Europe and North America. In the second form of commercial farming, that is the mixed farming, we will discuss that what it is and where the areas it is mainly practiced. As the name refers, mixed farming, in the mixed farming, livestock are reared along with the farming of food crops and fodder for animals. As the food crops, generally the cereals and vegetables are grown, and fodder is mainly grown for the animals that are reared. In this type of farming, generally the dairy animals and poultry animals are reared to get milk, meat, hides, etc. With the modern and good quality of machines and other tools, it is mainly done. And the reason where it is practiced are Southeast Asia, Africa and Europe, etc. In the next form of commercial farming, plantation, we will know about its meaning and where it is practiced. Plantation. Under the plantation, only a single crop is grown on the slopes of the areas, hilly areas, such as the crops are banana, tea, coffee, cashew, rubber, etc. skilled labor, skilled labor and efficient machinery with a huge amount of fund or investment, it is mainly practiced in the tropical areas of the world. So yes, for tea production, for the production of tea, the main reasons in which the tree are grown are Sri Lanka, well known for the tea plantation, Malaysia for rubber, and Brazil are well known for the plantation of coffee. So yes, now we are going to conclude the part 2 of the chapter.